Below are the three expressions we simplify on this video. This is part three of the distributive property. We're going to be simplifying more complex expressions where there are more negative numbers and distributing with negative numbers, etc. So let's begin with this problem. If you want, you could put the video on pause and try it on your own first. Okay, so we're going to start by doing the distributive property. There are three places I have to do the distributive property. I mean, we have the 5 needs to be distributed to both of these terms. The negative 2, key is to think of this as negative 2, not just 2, is going to be distributed. And this is just a minus sign that's going to be distributive. Now remember, a minus sign could be thought of as a negative 1. You could also change all subtraction to adding the opposite, but I think sometimes that's a little bit more cumbersome for a lot of students. So let's go through this. We've got 5. Remember, there's no negative sign in front of it, so that means positive 5. So we have 5 times 3x. That will be 15x. Then we have 5 times negative 8, so that would be minus 40. Now we've got minus 2 times x, that will be negative 2x. And here is the trick. We've got a negative 2 times a negative 4. That'll be a plus 8. Okay, not a minus 8, not a minus 4. It's a negative 2 times the negative 4. And then we have minus, in parentheses, you just are going to change both things in the parentheses, or you can think of it as minus times x, which is just a minus x, and a minus times a 7. Remember, you could think of that as a negative 1 times a 7. So if it helps you, you could always put in a negative 1 in front of there if that's helpful to you. So we have minus 7. Now we want to add all the like terms. So let's see. The like terms will be the variable part x. So here are the three like terms with that variable part. So if you want to show that step, you could put those in parentheses. The 15x, I've got a minus 2x. Remember, sure you carry through with that negative sign. And a minus x. And if you want, you could put a 1 in front of it. You don't need to. Plus. Now, for the numbers, I have the negative 40, the 8, and the negative 7. So I've got negative 40 plus 8 minus 7. Now, you don't need to write out this third step here. That's up to you. I'm just showing you what the like terms are in parentheses. And then to combine like terms, we add the coefficients. So for this first one, you've got 15 minus 2 will be 13, and 13 minus 1 will be 12. So the coefficient will be 12x. What do we have over here? We have a negative 40 plus 8 minus 7. I'm going to think of that as 8 minus 7 first, because it is a plus in front of the 8. So 8 minus 7 is 1. Negative 40 plus 1 is negative 39. And so that is our answer. Now, if you have trouble doing this problem without showing all of the steps, I'm going to go ahead and do this one more time, showing all the steps. If this makes perfect sense to you, you can sort of skip over this next part. All right, here's the problem again. Now, I really showed pretty much all the steps in the last one, but what I mean is if you want to change all subtraction to adding the opposite first. So if you did that, you would first rewrite everything. So this would be 3x plus a negative 8, okay? And this would be plus a negative 2 times an x plus a negative 4. I'm not putting the parentheses around the negative numbers because there just gets too many parentheses in this problem if you do that. And then I think of this minus as plus a negative 1 times x plus 7. Some people prefer to change all subtraction to adding the opposite before they do the distributive property. So this is just an alternate way of doing it. Now when I do the distributive property, I'm going to show all the steps here. This will be 5 times 3x. Plus 5 times negative 8, plus negative 2 times x, plus negative 2 times negative 4, plus negative 1 times x, plus negative 1 times 7. Ran out of room here. And now we could do our multiplications. So we have 5 times 3x, that's 15x. Then I have plus negative 40, plus negative 2x. Plus, well, negative 2 times negative 4 is 8, plus negative 1x, plus negative 1 times 7 is negative 7, and now you could add your like terms at this point. Instead of writing those all out again, let's see. If I put the like terms that have the x part together, that will give me, again, 15 minus 2 is 13 minus 1. Will that give me 12x? And then if I'm going to combine the constants together, again, negative 40 plus 8, you can think of as negative 32, minus 7 is going to be a negative 39. So you do get the same answer. Takes a little bit more writing, but if it's easier for you, this is just an alternate way to do the same problem. I'm going to do the rest of them using the other method where we don't change all subtraction to adding the opposite, etc. It just gets kind of long and complicated for most people doing it this way. But if it's easier, do it. Okay, here's another problem, kind of long and complicated. Let's go ahead and do the distributive property. So we're going to do the 2 here to each term inside the parentheses. So I'm multiplying through by the 2. So that'll be 2 times 3x is 6x. And 2 times negative 8 makes it a minus 16. Then we're subtracting what's in this parentheses, right? So that means you just change the signs because you're subtracting a 4x, so it ends up being a minus 4x. See how what was in parentheses changes from a 4x to a minus 4x? And then you're doing minus a negative 9, that'll be a plus 9. Again, in the parentheses was minus 9, it changes to a plus 9. That's the way to remove a parentheses if you have a minus sign outside. Then we're going to have to do, so I just did this, right? Now we're going to do the negative 3 times each term in this parentheses. So we have a minus 6x, right? And then we have a negative 3 times 6. That'll be a negative 18. And then I have this minus 5x just hanging out there in front. I mean, in the end. So now we need to combine the like terms. So let's see, there's the x terms. I'm going to just underline them so it's easy to see. Do you notice how I have a 6x and a minus 6x? Basically, that's going to be 0 right there. So we've got the negative 4x and a negative 5x together adds up to a negative 9x. You have to be very careful with adding with positive and negative numbers, subtracting, etc. Now let's do the numerical parts, the constants. There's only three constants. So I have negative 16 plus 9 and negative 18. I'm just going to go left to right. Negative 16 plus 9 is negative 7, and then I have a negative 7 and a negative 18. That makes negative 25, so it's minus 25. Now keep in mind, I'm adding like terms, don't multiply. It doesn't mean negative 9x times negative 25. Let's do one more. Here's one for you to try. Put the video on pause and try it. Okay, we have to distribute. You can do this. Don't worry about the fractions. So we have to distribute the 1 half to everything in the first parentheses. So we have 1 half times 7x, right, minus the 1 half times 9. Now, if you want, you could put plus 1 half times negative 9, but basically there's still just going to be one minus sign, correct? And then we need to distribute the negative 5 halves to the next parentheses. So remember, it's a minus 5 halves. So I have negative 5 halves times x. Now what's going to happen when you do a negative 5 halves times a negative 3? That's going to change to a plus. So remember, that's going to change to a plus, negative times negative. And we have 5 halves times 3. And then we have this minus 6 hanging out on the end. Okay, so this first one, this was a 1 half. So nothing cancels. So that's just 7 halves x. Nothing cancels here. That's going to be 9 halves. And then what do I have? Negative 5 halves x and 15 halves minus 6. So we need to combine the like terms. It's probably easier to deal with the, let's see, the x terms here. We've got 7 halves and we have minus 5 halves. So with fractions, what do? You have to have a common denominator, which I do have, and so then I'll have 7 minus 5. That's 2 halves x, right? 2 halves x? That's 1x, for those of you who could do that in your head. And then what do I have for the constants here. Let's first do the negative 9 halves and the plus 15 halves. Again, I have a common denominator. So it's going to be halves. Negative 9 plus 15, that will be 6 halves. So that's plus 6 halves, x. And those of you who do it in your head, you might write 3x. And then, I'm sorry, that wasn't an x, that's just 6 halves, minus 6. So I have here, what? I've got x plus 3 minus 6. Last thing is combining the 3 minus 6, those are the like terms, x minus 3, and that's it.